Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going up to the Hubble Deep Space Telescope, and we're going to look at one of these amazing images that Hubble returned to planet Earth, and there's something that appears in one of these spectacular images that just looks out of place. We're going to come back and take a closer look at this fascinating photo here in just a moment. Also in this video, I've got a brand new picture slideshow, new sky phenomena photos sent in from all around the world. But first, here at the website, quick look at the Schumann Resonance. You can see a little bit of background noise, small spike about 4 hours ago. All in all, pretty quiet as the Earth-facing side of the sun is also quiet. You can see a couple of sunspots trying to develop right there. Those are Earth-facing. If anything were to come out of those sunspots, they would come directly towards the Earth. Right now, we're still monitoring this solar prominence. That's what you see here on the northeastern limb of the sun. That thing is about 10 times the size of Earth, and there's actually two what look like tall pillars. That is known as a solar prominence. That is highly magnetized plasma that has lifted up off the surface of the sun and could eject at any time. It's actually much, much bigger than what you see right here. This is just the wavelength that I chose. This is a combination of the 211, 193, and 171. This is one of my favorite combinations that I use when I view the sun, and that thing right there is known as a solar prominence, and that is a very large solar prominence indeed. Hopping over to the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera, looking at the seismographs that monitor the mighty supervolcano, a little bit of earthquake activity scattered around the caldera on some of the seismographs, but not all. See a little bit of magma intrusion here and there, especially at the lake over here on the northeastern side. See some unusual activity on the east northeastern side of the lake. But for the most part, pretty quiet. But anytime you have activity at a supervolcano, you got to keep in mind, it is a supervolcano. Coming over here to poweroutage.us, still have over 120,000 customers without electricity in Michigan as we are approaching a week now since this event occurred. At one time, there were over 850,000 customers without electricity as Michigan and many of the surrounding states around Michigan went through some severe thunderstorms about a week ago that created a multi-state power outage event. Michigan still getting the power back on with 120,000 customers without electricity. Coming over here to nullschool.net, checking out the Sahara Sand situation. I've stepped this forward to August 19th, about 3 days from now, and the model is predicting this sand plume to grow to nearly 3,000 miles long. I measured that distance over here at Google Earth, and it measures just over 3,020 miles. So the plume is growing. It's definitely not getting any smaller at the moment. It seems to be getting larger. I want to take you guys now over to the Hubble Deep Space Telescope. This is a collage that was put together back in March of 2021. Do you see that right there? Something looks out of place. Beautiful, as always, images from the Hubble Deep Space Telescope. I mean, these are absolutely incredible. But that right there looks out of place. We're going to zoom in. I'm going to do some enhancement work on that object, whatever it is, put it in slow motion, and try to figure out what we're looking at. It does not put off light. It appears to have some darker points on the edges of this thing, whatever it may be. Something appeared in the field of view of the Hubble Deep Space Telescope. Everything else you see are stars way off in the distance. This thing here appears to be, with respect to the other stars, fairly close to the Hubble Space Telescope. I've done some enhancement work to some of these still images, and here we go. This one here, I just simply darkened up the color, and you're going to see some darker points on the edge of this object, whatever it may be. Here it is, simply inverted. Light is dark, and dark is light, and you can clearly see this thing is not putting off any light at all. Everything else is putting off light. The darker points are bright light. This is dark, so it's appearing white in this particular image. Here's another enhanced image, and I want you to pay attention to these edges. There are circular, darker points on the edges and along this tail-like structure, whatever this thing is. I have no idea, guys. This is a new one for me. Never seen anything quite like this. It just looks out of place. Certainly not a background star. Okay, here we go. We're starting to get into these images that showed something like here, 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 and then there's two points back here that are darker. I don't know what that means. They're definitely different than the rest of the entire structure. They're darker points of interest right there on the edges and along the back tail feature. And here's what I've done. I've circled those areas. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 obvious ones. There might be another one here, and there might be another one there. Could be maybe 6 or 7. Don't really have any idea how big this thing is, as gauging depth perception here is a little bit difficult. It appears to be obviously closer to the Deep Space Telescope than the stars, but I don't know how close. I mean, this thing could be way off in the distance and be quite large. Then again, it could be much closer to the Space Telescope and not be quite as big. I don't know. But there's clearly something in this image that was returned by one of the finest satellites mankind has ever made, the Hubble Deep Space Telescope. Something appeared in the field of view back in March of 2021. Also in this video, I've got a brand new picture slideshow, new sky phenomenon photos sent in from all around the world. Ron and Tony from right out here in Arizona sent in this video clip and a still image of some very impressive big dark beams spanning across the sky right out here in Arizona. Newark, Delaware, Terry, ominous looking sky here. Big photogenic shelf cloud above Delaware. This was just a few days ago. There it was, very low to the ground and then spanning way up into the sky, multi-layered. Cambridge, Ohio, Stacy M, fiery orange sky at sunset. Big, tall, double-decker rainbow sent in by Debbie out of St. Petersburg Beach, Florida. This thing here is standing tall. Look at how tall that is. And that is exactly how I received the photo. That is unedited. Christina out of Miami, Oklahoma. These are classic Chinese lanterns drifting through the sky. Video footage sent in by Christine out of Oklahoma. Odessa, Texas, photo by Angela M of yet another big towering beam spanning across the sky, just like we saw from right out here in Arizona. Brittany P from Los Angeles, California, shared this photo with me. She was taking a photo of the sunset when this appeared in the photograph. She doesn't know what this is. I don't claim to know either. I'm just sharing it with you guys. Something showed up in her photograph that looks out of place. It doesn't look like a typical lens reflection or something like that. Doesn't look like a balloon. Obviously doesn't look like a plane or a helicopter. Don't know what it is. Don't claim to know. Just simply passing it along. Photo here sent in by Harry out of Newcastle, England, of what looks like a giant heart in the sky. How about that? That is incredible. Good observation, Harry. Jamie A. out of Jordan, Michigan. Big, bright pink sky that is influenced by Sahara Sand. Photo here sent in by Jason S. out of Peru, Indiana. Another spectacular fiery orange sunrise. These next photos were sent in by John F. He took some photos of these really unique clouds in the sky, and there's one that appeared down here in the bottom of the photograph that looks like the side view of a crocodile, or at least a crocodile's head. How about that? That's one enhanced. That's the same photo. I just simply enhanced it. Here's another one that I enhanced, and you can see what looks like an open mouth with teeth. There's the eye. There's the top of the head that goes back to the neck. Profile of a crocodile. Another photo by John F. of a fiery pink sky. More fiery pink clouds, pink and orange. Not exactly sure of the location. East Coast, Jake M. of some spectacular lightning. Las Vegas, Nevada, Juan C. More fiery orange skies. That is influenced by not only wildfire smoke, but probably Sahara Sand. Spectacular photo there of big sun rays spanning up into the sky. Got some here by L. Cartwright out of Oklahoma, coming down from the cloud. Photo here sent in by Kelly D. out of Christian, Mississippi, of what looks like a rainbow on top of the dark clouds. Justin out of Richmond, Virginia. Everything drone. Very cool photo here with a lot of contrast. Same thing here by Justin out of Richmond, Virginia. This next photo here is one of a kind out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, taken by Chris C. Looks like this rainbow is coming down on the car in front of them as they're driving down the interstate. How about that? That's not something you see every day. Rip H. out of Paris, California, took this photo of what looks like a perfect triangle sitting in the sky above Paris, California. Incredible observation of what clearly looks like a pyramid parked in the sky. Great job, guys. Keep the photos coming. If you have any photos you'd like to share, you can send those to reports at MrMBB333.com. All of the photos end up here at the Sky Phenomena Photo Gallery at the website, and sometimes I'll use them in a video just like you saw right here. Thanks for watching. Have a super day, and be safe out there.